Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We continue with the subject of norm and the approach of ICRP. ICRP decided to set a task group in order to develop a report, a publication about this issue. It was launched in 2007 and not 2010. A long time ago, it is not because the member of the task group slept during their meeting, but because the issue is not so easy to address. We are developing a future report, and it will complete a series about different kind of existing exposure situation, and some report has already published. And we expect to finish our work in 2005. First, we have to set the scene. As you know, norm activities is a wide range of industrial practices: mining, mineral process industry, coal, gas production, metal production, etc., etc. You well know that. And in this type of industry, the exposure may occur at different steps of the process, and it is another reason because there is a wide spectrum of industry and of problem. The characteristic of norm exposure, you heard some word about that. It is related to industrial processes, not always big industry, but generally professional activities. We have a wide range of practices, it is already said. The source at the beginning is natural source, and then it already exists, and it seems that it is not always as controllable as artificial sources. But sometimes it is modified, and then we can better control in such cases. The concentration of radioactive material may be deliberate or unintended, and it is another characteristic. We have a large variation of activity concentration, a large variation of distribution of exposure, and the dose may be low or high. Generally, they are low, but a large population is exposed to low dose, and then it is another characteristic. And as far as workers are concerned, their exposure may be adventitious. I mean, it is not fully part of their job. It means that we have many challenges to cope with norm exposure situation. Primary source is not or is only partially controllable. We have to take into account ubiquity and variability of source. It means that it's not always easy to determine what is added with the activity, the human activity. And then it is impossible to adopt a simple and generic approach because of the wide range of cases. Generally, in such activities, we are facing a lack of radiological protection culture, and progress will make time. then, having set the scene, we can see how such activities may be dealt with using the ICRP system of protection. You know that this system is structured with type of exposure situation, categories of exposure, and basic principle. As far as type of exposure situation are concerned, norm industry are a priori existing exposure situation. The primary source is not always controllable. Norm industry may create pathways and modifying concentration. The use of immaterial with activity concentration significantly higher than natural background. And the concentration may be consequential and unintended. But in some cases, they can be managed like planned exposure situation, and sometimes we can say that they are planned exposure situation. When existing source is removed and modified, when the concentration of norm is deliberate, and when and in case of modification, the source may be controllable. But as far as emergency exposure situation is concerned, we don't see example scenario for such extraordinary situation. This slide you already seen several times. It shows that we could have different cases. Normally, it's not so important because the management of every situation is under the same way. I mean, through optimization. Nevertheless, if you take the choice to manage a situation like a plan explorer situation from the beginning, you could have some nuances, and in particular in the meaning of the numbers which are used, those limits in particular. And experience shows that we are focusing generally about numbers. And as far as norm exposures are concerned, if it was already said, now we have more or less a picture of what are these activities and industries. And we can say that more or less we could manage them like plan explorer situation. But we are not totally sure it is appropriate for all cases. And then if we say from the beginning, yes, we can manage them then, as plan explorer situation, and if as long as we as it works, it's okay. But if it doesn't work, then we are in a situation of failure. And failure, if it is a real failure, okay, we have to take responsibilities. If the failure is due to the circumstances, not easy to control, lack of radiological protection culture, then we need to have reply. It is more or less like in case of a post-accidental situation, we have to deal with the system from the beginning. Then, category of exposure, the concerned categories have occupational or public exposure. Occupational, when the exposure can reasonably be regarded as being the responsibility of the operating management. And we can use occupational requirement both in plan and exposure and existing exposure situation. And the other type of exposure is public exposure for the public and for the worker who are not considered as occupationally exposed. Then the principle, justification. Justification means do more good than harm. And justification in case of norm industry, we have different, it is a key point because we have different things to see. The industrial process itself should be justified, but also a key point which is the reuse and recycling of residues. Today, in some cases, we claim that it is ecological to reuse the residues because it is minimizing the waste, but in some cases, these residues are used and disseminate exposure otherwise and in other places. And this radioactivity could be the main source in other places. I mean, for example, with building material, which is the main source of radon in some countries. Strategies of protection should also be justified. Optimization is a key point. It means that, like a piston, you have to arrange the manage the situation in order to keep the exposure as low as reasonably achievable. It could be through a management plan. I will not decline the different parts of such a management plan. It is globally the same as other type of exposure situation. Key point is to see what are the exposure, when, where, and to determine how to address this exposure. An aspect of the optimization is the dose restriction. Dose restriction, the purpose is equity in order to avoid to have a big tail in the dose individual dose distribution. And we have several tools at our disposition, reference level and dose constraint, which are both source-related tools implemented in the field of optimization. They are useful in every type of exposure situation. In terms of numbers, dose constraints is around 1 millisievert per year for the public exposure and 20 millisievert per year for occupational exposure. Reference level is for existing exposure situation, while those constraints is for planned. The range of number is more or less the same in the band 1 to 20 millisievert per year. And we consider that probably in such a case, a maximum to set a reference level appropriate for such situation would be of the order of 10 millisievert per year. And from those reference level, we probably should have to derive some criteria in activity concentration or in measurable quantities in order to manage day-to-day the situation. As far as the application of those limits is concerned, it is an individual related tool, normally reserved for planned exposure situation, and we have both occupational and public dose limits, and you know what are the numbers, and they are more or less in the same order of magnitude than dose constraint and reference level. I will finish with the graded approach, because as I started my intervention saying that we have a wide range of situations, different cases, different possibility to control the situation, and then it means that we have to adapt our approach to the current situation. The strategy then should be commensurate to risk and responsibilities, of course, with ambition, realism, and effectiveness. Graded approach means that not only you have to use proper number, not only you have to give a proper status of the number you are using, but also in the use of these tools, you have to make some degree. For example, in the enforcement of the related ambition, you could have different degrees. And about the consequence of exceeding a level of reference, it could be also depending on the situation. And sometimes, of course, it is not appropriate to start a process of optimization. And then we can use the concept of exemption. But I would like to insist on the fact that this concept of exemption should not be the driving concept for the management of norm industry. It is one tool among different other tools, but it is not the driver, because experience shows that for many industry in that field, people are generally focusing on some numbers in terms of exemption, and radical protection system is not black and white. You have to wonder what is the situation, who is exposed when and where, and to build a system of management and not to shift depending on one number or one another. For the workers, we will probably propose in the report the same approach than for radon exposure. You know, ICRP is finishing a report about radon, and with a graded approach for workers who are advantageously exposed, I mean, who are not considered as occupationally exposed. In such a case, of course, responsibilities remain on the shoulder of the employer, but these responsibilities may be another way than the occupational requirement, could be another approach, and with some steps. The first step could be to manage the situation regarding not directly the individual, but the place, and using the derived reference level, for example, in concentration. If you cannot solve the problem with this step, you go to the second step, which is to take action referring to the dose, and then we have to use some tools in order to see what is the dose, the real dose, the actual dose in the situation you are managing. And if you cannot comply with the reference level expressed in dose, then, of course, the third step could be to use occupational requirement and to consider the worker as occupationally exposed, and it means that you manage now directly the workers and not only the location. Thank you very much.